I can't remember. Ooh la la. If you expected the full song, this is not happening. Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers. Welcome back. In today's video, I'm answering to a tag that has been done by one of my fellow fragrance reviewer, Ash Friends, one of the most nicest person in this community, and sent in Snowdrop on Instagram, oh my lovely John. John, you've done a really interesting tag, which was, it was associating a band, a music or a singer to a fragrance. So you took all the letters of ABBA, as I remember, and you associated with all the fragrance. But for me, I'm gonna choose different groups and associate to one fragrance, make you like discover something or discover a bit more myself, because usually what I get as a comment is like, oh, I was not expecting you listening to that, but yes. So one of my favorite group is the Smiths, and the Smiths, if you don't know, is this really soft rock and roll, I would say, and it's a more sensitive sound, things like that. And I love the accent, and his voice is like a lullaby, and I just love it. And it's very hairy, it's very nostalgic, very British, obviously. So Morrissey, the singer, has got a very like nostalgic, charming voice, I would say, slightly like touch of femininity inside. So I thought what would be the best to describe the song, and for me that would be Burberry Brit, and this is Riven. And I really love this scent. It's really like relaxing scent for spring, it's perfect. But so, you know, it's British, smells like an English tea, and it's a very romantic scent, because I don't know, I think there's lavender inside, but it's very soothing, relaxing, vanilla like, very cozy, and it's supposed to be like you going out and stuff like that, but for me it's more like a relaxing scent. So I won't go clubbing with that, but yeah, it's really an interesting one. It's a cheapie, and yeah, if you want a floral tone without being too ladylike, this is the ladies version, but it smells not that ladylike, to be honest, and I think that could be perfect. And it obviously talk about music. It's a very electric type of scent. Then the next group I wanted to talk about is the New York Dolls. So this is very, very old fashioned, very obviously. We change a bit the fact, but the New York Dolls are all usually symbolized by their lipstick, you know, and they were like, you know, all this makeup and stuff, blah, blah. It's very extravagant. So I thought, you know, what could be describing them? And I thought Missia. Missia is from Chanel, and it's like a rose violet scent. It smells very ultra powdery, and what makes me do the link between the two is that Missia was the friend of Coco Chanel, and she was basically doing like cabaret, singing, you know, performing, stuff like that. So she was really on stage, and she was always symbolized by a lot of like makeup and things like that. And the scent of Missia represent also the scent of some of the makeup that Chanel had before, so that's why it smells so beauty like and like a lipstick and a bit sticky. And I thought that would be the best to describe them. So it's really like a bomb, this fragrance. It's so overpowering in violet and rose, it's really intense, and I thought that would be perfect because the New York Dolls are very intense. This is the least I can say. Then one of my favorite group that I listen all the time is the Velvet Underground, and mainly like Lou Reed. I love this guy. I mean, let's take a walk on the wild side, you know what I mean? People that don't know this kind of music will be like, what is she talking about? More like a calming and relaxing music. If you think of the 60s, 70s, a big psychedelic rock and roll, this is definitely what it is. It drives you to somewhere else. It's very poetic, very weird. It's really the 70s, probably like sitting on your sofa, you're listening to Heroin. If you don't know this song, you need to listen to it. It's really like strange. It's transport you somewhere different, but it's very calming. So I love this type of rock and roll, and I would say I chose Psychedelic Love from Initio, and this is really nice scent. Even though it's got a bit more feminine tone, I thought that would be perfect because, you know, one of the songs have Lou Reed's makeup, so why not? I just think that would be perfect. There's this very floral tone, it smells like a narcotic, and this is really the vibe of the Velvet, like very weird narcotic. Obviously there were no angels, if you know what I mean, so I felt this intoxicating, overpowering scent would be perfect. It smells also very smooth, so I would say, yeah, if you want to listen to your vinyl, have a glass of I don't know what. Then one of my favorite group is the Libertines. The Libertines, it's Peter Doherty, Carl Barat singing, and I'm just like, I love them so much. This is part of the reason that I went to live in London, because I love British music so much, and I think the Libertine marked the era with something very different, and this is like a revolution in the industry of music. I mean, Peter Doherty is not a really nice guy, but he's a genius, so that's it. He's really, really good in music, and he's a poet as well, you know, all the poet like Baudelaire are a bit twisted, but yeah, I really love what he's doing, so I can't say anything. But their song smell a bit more dirty, sticky, that give me that vibe of stickiness, leather jacket, very like British boho style, like all over the place. So for me, I chose Muscravageur from Frédéric Malle. This is very sexy fragrance that smell not really that much animalic, but it does smell like very primitive, and I think this would be very good on them. That very intoxicating musky scent, a lot of musk that smells cottony, powdery, and very sexy, dirty, you know, this type of smell. So I think that would be perfect. I went to see them on my birthday, and it was amazing. The other group I wanted to talk about is The Killers. The Killers, definitely a bit more modern, it's a bit more mainstream, what I'm gonna say, in the music industry. Like, it's really like something easy to listen to, even though I love them so much. Plus, I've been seeing them also on stage, and they were amazing, really like so powerful, energetic. He's so intense, his voice is brutal, beautiful, and for me that would be a Tuscan leather, because it's an easy to wear leather, even though it's quite striking. And also Brandon Flowers, the singer, has got a little bit of sensitivity as well when he's talking about love stories. I love it, and there's this touch of strawberry in Tuscan leather that I think that would be perfecto. I don't know where I've got this Italian accent. I'm so sad I can't put like music on my video, because otherwise it's gonna get banned, but it's so sad. But yeah, like The Killers, I love it. One of my favorite, I love also their video clip. If you didn't see the clip, they're so nice. They usually tell you a lot of stories, and there's one that is called Here Is Me, and it's a video clip that's been created by Tim Burton, and you can really see his touch. And there's one of my favorite actress that is inside, and it's Winona Ryder. So Here Is Me, it's so nice, very nostalgic when I listen to it, and a bit like emotional, but it's fine. So yeah, definitely Tuscan leather. And then there's Oasis. So Oasis is the first song I learned how to play on guitar, so my guitar skills is really bad, okay. Never find really the time. Oasis is the 90s, is that dirty rock and roll, a bit more aggressive, you know, cigarettes and alcohol, iconic. Wonderwall, obviously iconic. Supersonic is my favorite song from them. Beautiful. It's heavier in the guitar. The guitar feels much more heavier than before. It's not that soothing rock and roll. It's not that romantic rock and roll. It's not that indie rock and roll. It's very like much more heavier. So 100% that's Fahrenheit from Dior. That is a bit gasoline-like. I feel that's perfectly representing the spirit of Liam Gallagher and Noel. So yeah, definitely that. The last one I want to talk about is The Strokes, so it's more modern rock and roll, obviously this one. I love Giselle Casablancas, the singer, I absolutely adore him. I love his song since I'm a child, it's all my teenage life. I was completely obsessed, I was wearing like those high socks in black over my knees and my hat and my lipstick and my perfect toe, and then we were going dancing and stuff and going crazy. This is a bit more indie rock and roll, even though it's quite approachable when you get it. It's more crazy, it's more funny, it's more happy, I would say. By the way, Julian Casablancas made the advertising of a fragrance at 0 decibel that I didn't really like, but I appreciate that he was inside. Yeah, I would probably choose for him Ombre Lézard, that should be quite nice for Tom Ford, but if I want to go something different, I would definitely choose John Varvatos, Dark Rebel. I think it's an indie rock and roll, dark, intense black scent that could be really suitable for my dear Julian and the Strokes. Ah, but yes! So that was the quick tag I've done, and I hope you did enjoy it. I love to talk about music and to tell you a bit more about myself and my taste. Obviously, I listen to modern stuff too, but if I have to choose, I would go directly rock and roll. And this is like my double personality. I can be a little princess and a little cupcake and suddenly transform into that. So, I hope you did enjoy as much as I did, and I will see you soon. Bye now!